but an hour queue for a Hello Kitty latte is my limit.
These were the toilets. Is the Cartoon Museum, which is just around the corner.
Look at that telly, that's hilarious.
I feel like I should have some kind of big life update for you guys now that I'm back on YouTube. Literally no update at all. Oh, I got fined £130 last week for doing a U-turn where I wasn't meant to do a U-turn. Granted, there were two signs, so it definitely was my fault, but what a waste of money, huh? I am looking forward to spring. I think I'm trying to like make out like it's not that cold today, but I'm kind of cold and wish I'd bought my gloves, but I'm gonna take you somewhere. We are gonna go to a public toilet for a coffee and maybe some food if the queue is not too big. Yes, you heard me right. Let's go. Blasting out music. No, I wanted a quiet coffee shop. But look at this. A little seat, not quite in the urinals. Look at that. All the original features. I think this is like a listed little cafe. Oh, seasonal lattes. A pistachio latte. Even a blueberry matcha latte. I'm trying to reduce my caffeine, guys. It's getting out of hand. What should we get? It's lunchtime, but it's always time for breakfast, I find, in London. Those croissants, those sandwiches that we saw looked insane, right? Oh, bacon roll. I feel like people might think that that's crazy expensive, but that's a London price for you. I think it's quite reasonable. Builder brunch, which is why it's so busy in here. But I'm thinking maybe one of the sandwiches. Maybe. I got the pistachio latte. Can't wait for it to be warm enough for us to get iced drinks. A few more weeks. I feel like the lighting in here is not very complimentary. Let's give it a go. Also really hot. Don't you hate it when you get a latte and it's cold? Oh my God, it's amazing. Might be the best latte I have ever had in my life. And yeah, there's a little queue outside now, so it's getting busy. And we're getting the full urinal experience. So yeah, I guess these were the toilets, which is kind of weird and kind of gross at the same time, but super cool. I went for the tomato and roasted pepper soup, which looks amazing. Honestly, this drink is insane. I really do like that artwork. Also, I'm glad I'm getting the roasted tomato. What is it? It was roasted peppers and tomato soup, because before Christmas, I realized that my teeth were like a little bit too white. It was giving Simon Cowell without the bank balance, so hopefully this will stain my teeth a little bit. Also, the service in here is 10 out of 10. It's so nice. But this soup is just what I needed.
It is strange, like how many people have taking a piss here. I didn't quite finish all my food. I'm getting my latte to go because it's amazing, but this is boiling and spicy and it's just a bit much. I was moaning I was cold. I'm like boiling now. Look at the state of me. I'm so flushed. Also, I need to go makeup shopping because like all my makeup's run out. Real life problems. Yeah, like what has happened? It feels a bit weird when you're like eating your food, but this place is really cute again. Crazy busy.
Thank you. I have to ask, is there actually even a toilet in here? The irony, thanks. Sorry, thanks. Ooh, fresh air, oh my God, that soup has warmed me up. Not gonna lie, that was way cuter than I thought it was gonna be. It was really hard to vlog, so I hope it kind of came across. You got the experience, guys, because that's what this is all about. You coming with me on a little stroll somewhere. Ooh, and somewhere I have always wanted to go and have never been, and I think we should go, is the Cartoon Museum, which is just around the corner. I think it's like 10 quid, and they have a Wallace and Gromit thing on at the moment. What is this video? Did you expect us to eat in a urinal and then go to a comic museum? Well, I should say Cartoon Museum. I feel like everyone's gonna get mad that I just said comic, but yeah, I love that type of thing, and I love Wallace and Gromit, and a couple of people have said to me it's quite good. It's like quite an intimate little, right, let's not get run over, like little place, so let's see. Maybe I should have bought tickets. This is crazy because I actually used to work just up the road there. And I didn't realize that the Cartoon Museum was here. Maybe it's new, I don't know. I probably should have Googled that. But yeah, the wrong trousers turns 30. Can't quite see it, but that makes me feel kind of old. Is that meant to be Boris? I think it might be. Oh, look at this. I'll show you a little bit. I just want to go and have a look around here. I've always wanted to come. I think it's like £9 or like £9.50. It's really cute. It's got like the full story, obviously, of how they came up with all the imagery. How cool is that? All the animation that they needed to create. It's very quiet in here. Oh my God, what an iconic scene. And some of the storyboards. How cool is that? I think even if you're not a fan, it's cute to see all the little sketches. That was a little bit different to what I thought it was going to be. It was so quiet, so I hope I did it justice by showing some of my fave pieces, but I think I wasn't aware, or maybe I'm aware now, that cartoons starting in like the early 1700s was really about politics and joking about upper versus lower class and basically taking the piss out of rich politicians, which I'm kind of all for. So it was good to see like the different styles, and there was one that was like on copper. I think I may have shown you that, and it was just really clever how they first created them. But I would say I think the Cartoon Museum is really not for kids. But yeah, I was a bit I'd give it a 6 out of 10, maybe 6.5 out of 10. Do I say this? I might regret saying this, but I'm gonna try and do in March 2 vlogs a week. We will see. I'll do it for like 1 week and then be like, guys, I can't do it anymore. Yeah, but anyway, on to the next. Black, and I'm kind of okay with it, so I hope you're okay with me wearing navy and black together. I'm okay with it. I like this coat, it's cozy. But about 4 minutes ago, we were having a wonderful dining experience in a men's urinal. Now for the next few minutes, we're gonna go to this gorgeous cute cafe, that is what it's called. I'll show you in a moment. I'm outside Somerset House on this gorgeous Sunday morning, and I'm kind of living for it. So, first, I've got a bit of time to kill, and I'm thinking about holiday because I need to talk to you and I need your help. Now, although London is my true love, I have actually booked some flights to go to California. Not until the back end of the year, but I'm excited, and I need your help with some tips, but I have been using the wonderful NordVPN to help me on my booking process. As you know, I'm a big fan of NordVPN. They are the fastest VPN in the world, and I've used them for quite a few years now, actually. But as you're aware, depending on what country you're in, depends on what price you're gonna pay for things like flights, for hotels, and for car hire. I've never driven in America, by the way. It can't be that difficult, right? And they have this thing called threat protection, which protects you from things like ads and trackers. So I will say, I've been changing my virtual presence to go to the US. What did I look up earlier? That I was in France, then I was in Germany and Canada. And I could see so many different prices for a bunch of hotels that I've been looking up. And like I say, my car hire as well. But I do need some recommendations on hotels and things to do in California. So can you please help me? If you are interested, to give it a go, it's got a 30-day money-back guarantee. So if you're not sure, you've got that protection. And yeah, make sure you click the link in the description, my link. It's the best link, and you will get an incredible offer. On a 2-year deal, you'll get an additional 4 months for free. We love a freebie, so definitely go and check it out. There are so many sirens out today. Also, King's College there. That reminds me of a number of years ago, and a lot of blue WKD was consumed I have not been to Somerset House in quite a while, actually. I used to come here a lot with work. There's always lots of like fashion exhibitions and stuff here.
It looks so gorgeous. I'm so glad. Spring is coming. It's about 6 degrees. My hands are a bit pink. Apologies. I always forget to bring my gloves. But yes, let's go to cute. Some might say I say that word too much, which I think is fair feedback. No, I wouldn't usually vlog this type of thing, but yeah, cute, the irresistible rise of cuteness in contemporary culture. My ticket was £18.50. I booked it a couple of days ago, but you don't have to pay, obviously, to go into this section, and this is where the ice rink is as well during Christmas. Oh, what time is it? Art Box Cafe, which is here all the time, and it has a Hello Kitty overlay. Right, I think the cafe's over here.
Literally gonna be my face when I see how busy it is in here.
God, I love this building, it's so pretty. Let's head on in. Please don't be too busy.
See, this is the thing, we love everything cute, and there is a huge line. The guy just came out and said it's an hour wait. I'm not waiting an hour for a cute coffee. Anyway, let's go into the exhibition.
I feel like this vlog has turned into an artsy vlog. Me, when I saw that there was an hour queue for the cafe. But look at all of these cats from like the early 80s. So they've got quite a bit on, obviously, where all this cuteness came from. Some Japanese artists. Oh my God, they have so many products in here. I do like Hello Kitty. I can't say I'm like a hardcore fan, but it's interesting to hear that it was created in like the mid 70s to try and entice people to buy things for packaging. And it has certainly worked. It's like a global phenomenon. Look at that telly, that's hilarious. Oh my gosh, I love things like that, like the old school camera. I was gonna buy a disposable camera soon actually and use it with my nieces. I think it would be fun. Oh, look at the toaster. Oh, look at that. That's a good photo op. Oh, I feel bad. They all like staple gun to the wall. This artist collects stuffed animals from thrift stores. I'm guessing that's him. I like that one. He looks like he's been loved a lot. I kind of wish Tamagotchis were still a thing here in Europe. I had so many, and now she won't be watching this, but I had one and I accidentally dropped it in my drink. And my dinosaur, my T-Rex, died. Some of this is kind of creepy, actually.
Do you know what? In this vlog, obviously, I've gone to the Cartoon Museum and this cute exhibition. It's making me think that maybe my expectations are not right, because a lot of the, apart from Hello Kitty, but a lot of like the big characters that you and I would recognize, I guess the commercial ones, they probably don't have the rights to like show the history of it, like because it's such a mixed company event. Do you know what I mean? So. Yeah, it was okay. I'm not sure if that makes sense, but yeah, I think I wanted to see a little bit more of like the actual history, maybe some like a bit more on like the fashion and how that has really impacted modern fashion, which it has with the kawaii impact. I don't know, and a few more bits would have been nice to see, but anyway, this is not why you clicked on the video. Do I attempt the cute cafe, or should we go along the south bank? It is really sunny.
Yeah, let's go to Covent Garden.
Instead, here's a picture of a coffee that I would have got. I tried. People's etiquette at exhibitions is just shocking. Shocking, like stood right in front so no one else can read the blurb. In the way, screaming children, and look, I love kids, but that's just not a good one to go to with babies. There was a lot of babies in there and a lot of bored kids. So anyway, my review is, I think I would give that like a 6 out of 10. I feel like this is a 6 out of 10 kind of vlog. It was okay, definitely not worth £18.50. I think that was worth maybe like 12 quid. Everything's just a lot more than it. I think it should be. And there's so many good free things to do in London. Speaking of which, make sure you are subscribed because I will be doing more things to do in London, whether it costs money or not. It costs me, but it's free for you to watch. So make sure you are subscribed.
Cuban sandwich, mojo pork. Okay, we're going to have a proper look around. There's loads of little like food stalls and Seven Dials just off Covent Garden. I think this is like a good grab and go. Oh, some dumplings. Oh, yum. A wheel cake. Wow, what are they? This back in the day used to be like the shopping place for teenagers to go. Now it's a huge food hall. These don't really exist in London. Obviously this one does. So it's like a sushi bar in a way, but it's cheese. Cheese board with pairings. I actually just need like actual food though. I think this is good for like little sharing things. Oh my gosh, let's get it in focus first. This camera is very troublesome, but yeah. Look, see, it's like cheese after cheese. But I definitely just need like normal food. Another time, I promise. They got a huge Syrian place as well. I'm overwhelmed, where should we go? Oh, the light, I love it. I'm gonna go for three dumplings with chicken. Let's see what that's like. But I really wanna try a wheel cake as well. And as I wait for my dumplings, I'm gonna get a chocolate and vanilla wheel cake. Yum. Oh, I went for three just in case I didn't want the texture too much. What is the white stuff? And yeah, my wheel cake, which we'll try in a sec. But yeah, there's loads of seating. It's, what time is it? About 1:45 on a Sunday. Pretty chill. Dumpling review. They're okay. They're a little flavorless. The chicken is a smidge bland, but this is really nice. Whatever it is, yum indeed. Ooh, look at this cake. Oh, that is yummy. It was, I think it was £3.20 and it's not too sickly. Super scrum. But an hour queue for a Hello Kitty latte is my limit. I have made a few errors with this camera already. When I went to that cafe earlier on, I explained the history, all about it. It was amazing. My little intro, but the audio did not pick up because I pressed the button on the side of the camera, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, my fault. So I'm gonna try and get used to this. You may notice this is a different camera to my iPhone 15. And remember, these videos are all in 4K. Quite often on YouTube, actually, whether you're watching this on your phone or on the telly, it defaults to like 1080p, which is like a lower res. Some people only film in HD. So make sure like you go, scroll along to the little kind of wheel settings and have a look, because even when I watch other people's videos, it doesn't default to 4K. So if you have 4K on a telly, it's kind of worth it. Yeah, I think I may have mentioned earlier in the video, unless I had to cut it out. I have a plan. I have this countdown to Easter plan, and I'm gonna, yeah, try and do two videos a week. So let me know what you wanna see in London. I will do my best. I basically have a notes in my phone that has so many things in it, and I don't know when I'm gonna be able to film them all, but even little things like going to the cheese bar, I need to bring this camera with me more, because I go to places like today, I would never have brought my camera with me. I would have just like gone out on my own and gone and done this like after work, or well, Sunday like it is today. So let me know if you like these kind of videos, and then I will do ones that are more specific to like a retail store or like going out for lunch. We have an afternoon tea booked, for example. Because I like doing these over a couple of days. I'm so glad it's sunny, and also I cannot wait to do a video where I'm not wearing a coat. I'm so sick of wearing a coat. Maybe I should just move to California. No. I love the UK most of the time. Oh, that was spicy. I'd give those a 7 out of 10. They were really nice. And you got quite a lot, I think, for the money. I think it's reasonably priced in here for London. So it's quite good. Obviously, if there's a group of you, or you just want to get a snack. It's quite loud in here, but yeah. Wheel Cake Island for the win. That was so good. Okay, now I am full. Let's head on out. Something I find wild in London is the TikTok craze. I don't know if this place is to do with TikTok. I've been here. Like, it was good. But why is it so, look at that, a queue. Can you believe that? Maybe I need to be more patient. Maybe I need to accept that I need to queue an hour for pretty latte art. I do love Hello Kitty, but I'm not waiting an hour. The vlog is over, guys. Like the video, please. It feels good to be back on YouTube. Subscribe, check out NordVPN, and I will see you when? Next Friday at 6 p.m. Bye, guys.